How to 4x your sales with the same amount of customers. Video 2 of 2. Hey, this video is what you need if you want to improve your sales. If you want to 4x your sales, who wouldn't want to 4x your sales? By the end of this video, you're going to know 13 ways you can 4x your sales with the same customers you've already got. Now, this is video 2 of 2, which means there's a 1 of 2. And in the description below, I put the link to that so you can go back and watch video 1 if you haven't done so. It's okay. It's okay if you continue on with this video right now. You don't have to stop. No, you don't have to stop. You can go ahead, go through this video, and then go back and watch the first one. Okay, let's get going. Okay, the first thing you want to do is keep your message consistent throughout your entire website. I'm going to put an image up on the screen here. This is Air Canada, and it says it's the summer of great rates. Get our lowest prices guaranteed. Air Canada book now. Now, that is a display ad for Air Canada. Now, the landing page, when you get to the landing page, here it is, Air Canada. It's got the same colors, it's got the same logos, it's got everything the same right here. And that way, when a user clicks and comes through to this page here, they're gonna get the same feeling, okay? It looks the same. Number 14 is answer every question and address every objection in your ad copy. So what you're going to need to do is when you're doing one of these sales pages, you want to sit down and think about all the questions somebody may have about your product. And then you want to think about all of the objections they may have from buying your product. Now, we sell a whole bunch of different products. One of them is survival food. So on that page, I'm going to try to write ad copy that's going to address their objections, why they wouldn't buy that product. And then I also want to answer all the questions about what they may have about that product. That helps that ad copy actually sell the product. Understand, we're not one-on-one. All they've got is that page right there. So having that page in front of them, it's got to do all the stuff that I would do if I was sitting across from them talking one-on-one. Super important that you do that. Number 15, give away as much as you possibly can for free. Okay. If you give away a lot to people, you're going to develop this thing called reciprocity. Reciprocity means you gave to me, so I feel like I have to give back to you. Now, if you give a lot of information to somebody, if you give a lot of value to somebody, the only way they can pay you back is by buying your product or service. Pretty good trade-off, right? I think it is. So make sure you give away as much as you possibly can for free. Number 16 is you want to create a really good buyer avatar. Okay. Who is your customer? What are their age? What is their gender? You know, what is their income level? What kind of things do they like? What kind of things do they dislike? It's really important that you do that, because if you can't do that, it's really difficult to target anybody. Don't think that your product is for everybody. It's not. And the problem is, if you write ad copy for everybody, you actually target nobody, because it doesn't speak to anyone. You're not calling anybody out. So it's super important that you do that. The next thing you want to do is implement tiered pricing. Now, we do this with some of our survival food. You know, we'll say you get one case and you can get this discount. You get 5 cases, you'll get this discount. And you get 10 cases and you get this discount. So that tiered pricing actually will bump up their thinking. They're thinking, well, I'm going to save, you know, I don't know, $50 on this one, but I'll save $100 on this one. I'll save $500 on this one. Whatever the tiered pricing you have, that really will increase your sales exponentially. Number 18, you can add a add-in pop-up on your page to push them over the edge. So I'm going to put an example up here on the screen. Get 10% off plus free shipping on your next purchase of whatever it is, $49, if you join our email list. That's one way of going about it. You could have a discount coupon right there. There's a lot of things you could do to have in that pop-up. Now, be careful. If you're running ads, ads don't like pop-ups. And what I mean by that is, if you run somebody to your page and it's an ad page, okay, and you have a pop-up on it, you will get your ad disallowed. So this is for pages that people aren't going to be going to from a paid ad. Number 19, I can't even believe I have to say this, but I do. You want to grow your online sales by having responsive pages. What do I mean by responsive? I mean pages that are going to work on mobile phones and that are going to work on an iPad or a laptop. Now, I'll tell you, I never thought it would be true, but the majority of the people that come to all my pages are on mobile phones. They just are. They don't use laptops much. You know, I remember I thought I was really, you know, ahead of the curve, because about 4 years ago, 5 years ago, I got rid of my desktop. I don't own a desktop. And I thought I was really ahead of the curve, but now it looks like I've got to get rid of my laptop. I don't want to do that. I like my laptop, so I'm keeping my laptop. They can't take that from me. But most people actually are on mobile devices nowadays. So understand, since they're going to see it on a mobile device, you want to make sure that your pages are responsive on mobile devices. Super important that you do that. Number 20, impress your customers with follow-up. That's right. When they opt in, when they buy a product, when they opt in for something that you have, make sure you have some type of email sequence follow-up that actually welcomes them and makes them feel good and gives them free content and offers them different things. But make sure you don't offer them something as soon as they sign up. You don't want to do that. What you want to do is welcome them in, give them some value first, give them some free content first, and then you can offer them something. But make them feel warm and fuzzy. That's super important. Make sure you do that. That's number 20. Number 21 is nail your value opposition. I want to put a graphic on the screen here real quick. This is a customer value proposition right here. It's the 10 characteristics of a great value proposition. You can see a number one is embedded in great business model. Number two focuses on what matters most to customers. Number three focuses on unresolved pains. Number four target few job pains and gains, but extremely well. Number five goes beyond functional jobs and addresses emotional and social jobs. Number six align with how customers measure success. Number seven focuses on jobs, pains and gains, but people will pay a lot of money for. And number eight differentiate from competition. Number nine outperform competition substantially on at least one dimension, possibly more. Number 10, it is difficult to copy. Okay, if you can nail that, guys, if you can nail that right there, you're obviously going to sell more products to your customer. Number 22, use the voice of your customer for your ads. Okay, so I'm gonna put a graphic up here, and this one here is really, I like this one here. This is FreshBooks, and they say try it free for 30 days. And then they've got number two right here. I like this, easy to use. Okay, they talk about how the ease of use, because everybody's worried about how hard it's going to be to use. Number three, work anywhere. They give you an idea, you know, with FreshBooks your business is accessible from any computer, mobile device, iPhone, iPad, Android. And number four, save time billing. FreshBooks is built for small business owners to get organized and get paid. You'll be tracking time, logging expenses and invoicing your customers. Now notice the operative thing here. They said for small businesses, they're not going after big businesses. That's not their target market, and they know that. And since they know that, they can call out small businesses, and small businesses kind of feel left out because they feel lumped into this big business thing and they feel like they don't really quite fit there. So they're smart enough on FreshBooks to call that out in their ad copy. Number 23, you want to pinpoint where your best attribution and conversion paths are coming from. Super important that you do that. Now the graphic I'll put on the screen here, we'll kind of look at that real quick, but it's got basic channel grouping path, and then it's got source path. Okay, so it's got social network direct, and the next one here is social network times two. The next one is direct times social network times two, and it walks you through all these things. And if you path out all this, one of the first things you should do if your conversion rates look low is to examine your attribution models and conversion pathways in analytics. Okay, you may be surprised to find that parts of your marketing campaign strategy that seem like conversion duds actually have a big influence on the online sales. For example, maybe organic search isn't a great channel for converting into sales, but people who find you first through organic search and then see a Facebook ad are highly likely to become a paying customer. So maybe that's what you need to do. You need to target those people first through some of those pathways, and then take those people and then target them through your ads. Number 24 is actually talk to people on social media. Okay, actually do that. This is a social media platform. This YouTube thing is really social media. And when you put a comment below, I'm probably going to answer you. I'm probably going to talk to you. I'm probably going to try to help you out. And I'm probably, no, definitely doing that for free, because I know that by doing that, it builds a loyalty to this channel. It builds a loyalty to you watching my videos. And by doing that, I'm going to get more views. And if I get more views, I get more distribution. More distribution means in the long run sales. Now I don't go in the short run. I always do the long game. Some of you may be out there for the short game. It never works. It never works. It's always the long term. Okay, that's where I'm going to get my loyal purchasers, people who buy my courses, of which I have below. And some people may look at those courses below and say, hey, I want that course. I listened to that guy. That information sounded good. I'm going for it. But it's a long-term gain. Okay, I have to provide you with good information before you're going to do that. And number 25 is use remarketing. Remarketing is basically people who have been to your pages, people who have opted in, people who have seen your ads, and you running another ad to them. It's super important that you do that. Okay, you gotta do that. Really, really important. So I hope this helps you out. You are now at the end of video two of two videos on how to improve your sales, okay, with the same customers, which is awesome. Okay, you don't have to go get more customers, and all these things relate to that. Can you do all 25 of these? I don't know, but if you do some of them, it will be better. Don't not do any of them because you can't do all of them. Does that make sense? Yeah, that makes sense. Don't not do any of them because you can't do all of them. It's really important. You know, I can't do every single thing I talk about even. It's impossible for me to do every single thing. I try to do as many as I can, but I can't always do that. Understand, just do what you can do and keep moving forward and make sure you keep doing new things. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really appreciate it. Don't forget, subscribe below if you haven't done so already, and that will make the bell appear. When the bell appears, you gotta ring it. Turn on all bell notifications so you're notified every single time I do a new video. I really appreciate you watching and being here. Thank you so much. I appreciate you on this channel. Hey, share this channel with your friends and family. Put your comments below, and I will see you in the next video. Hey, thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click that little bell right there so you can be notified every time I do a new video. Also, click on one of those videos there. Keep watching on my channel.